kind of got to get this one right the first time.
You got me begging you for mercy. I was born ready.
You got me begging. You did say, oh, that's higher than I imagined.
Now, you played against two Welsh boys in the Ashes. What do you think of them?
I'll try and do once.
Believe it or not, over 1,000 years ago, bears used to roam the countryside in Wales. But now we don't have enough room for them. Even one of our national parks isn't big enough to support one bear. So when you come somewhere like this and look over the Babeen Range and its river, you realise how important it is to leave somewhere for the bears. After all, their future is in our hands.
Welcome back. Well, Sir Alex's assistant, Mike Phelan, has been putting all the squad through their paces as they build up fitness levels in North America. We'll have some idea in a few hours' time where the players are at, just 4 weeks before the Premier League season begins.
Well, first of all, thank you, Matthew, for taking time out of your very busy schedule to meet up with me.
Not at all.
Now, I understand you've just landed a fantastic role in a new drama series with Calista Flockhart.
I have indeed.
Now, you've moved out here from Wales to make it big in the film world. And obviously, a lot of people have made it big from sitcoms and dramas just like this. Are you hopefully going to use this as a springboard to catapult into that film world?
Yeah, hopefully, yes. If we don't get picked up, then yes, you know, we'll start sniffing around the film houses and see what's going on.
Yeah, talking of being picked up, your role is a gay one in this drama. And you were saying that you've had quite a few admirers since.
Oh yes, they're very forthcoming, the boys.
You were quoted saying that you were going to play your butt off every night, and you certainly have.
Well, we have to. I mean, for us to beat teams and to be a playoff team, we're going to have to play harder than everybody else if we want to have a shot.
How important has this tour been for you?
This has been great, not only for our bonding, but just experience. Different situations. We had an overtime game, and now we had a nail-biting game here, which was phenomenal.
You secured those final points. How'd you feel?
I felt good. I missed the last free throw, which kind of was going to bother me tonight because I wanted to seal the deal. Fortunately, we got the ball out of bounds, and the game was over.
And do you think you've achieved everything you wanted to from this European tour?
I mean, as far as just us playing hard, executing, we have a lot of work to do. We made a lot of mistakes, but it was just good for us to finally play against somebody else instead of ourselves.
And have you enjoyed London?
I had a great time, and I hope they had a great time watching this. I hope we put a great show on for them.
We have. We had a fantastic time. Thank you so much, and all the best for the rest of the season.
Thank you. Thanks for having me.
This week, my mission, should I choose to accept it, is to stand on this 1940s biplane, 1,000 feet up in the air at 120 miles per hour. We're here tonight to look at the rising stars of amateur boxing in Wales. 11 bouts in total across the weights, including for the very first time at this event, a ladies' exhibition. So plenty of boxing action coming up in the next 60 minutes. And ringside, a man who is as much of a regular fixture at this event as the ring itself, Nicky Piper, who's in his element, I'm sure. Nicky, what's the atmosphere like?
Do you think that Prince William will be a better prince in the future?
It's very, very hard to say.
If you were Prince Charles's advisor, what would you tell him to do to win the people of Wales over?
Well, I'm delighted to be joined by a man who is very settled in this studio, David May. David, thanks for joining me. Now, the next few weeks are great preparation for the campaign ahead.
Now, you're a part owner of the Nets, aren't you?
Yeah, I own a bit.
So you've got a vested interest in them winning?
Yeah, you know, it's pre-season still, but, you know, just to set the tone for what we're trying to do this season. It's great.
You had a tough season last season, and now hopefully it's going to be a new era for you.
Yeah. You said it pretty much best.
Now then, you haven't performed in this arena before, have you?
No, this is a brand new one. I haven't been here yet.
When are you going to be here? Because Stevie Wonder was here last week and Kanye West next month.
I'll get here soon. You know, those are great performers. So hopefully I can live up to those two.
Well, hello there, Colin. Here I am in this fantastic new stadium surrounded by 20,000 screaming fans, all enjoying tonight's activities. Now, this stadium is unique to this country, and I'll show you some reasons why. Now, I'm standing on the concourse, which, as you can see, extends the whole entire circumference of the lower tier. Then, as I come down the steps, you will notice that there won't be any number supporting MK Dons next season because every single seat in the house is padded.
It's been a fantastic day and a success for everyone involved. I hope it's inspired you to take a look at the opportunities that polo can offer. And we look forward to seeing you here next year.
It's the first match I've been to. You know, half-time, it's not oranges. I think it's gas and air.
Is it off? I was expecting a bottle of Budweiser, to be fair. A bit disappointed about that.
Well, that can be arranged.
Now we're talking.
Have you been training for tonight?
I know. Believe it or not, I have, and it doesn't look like it. Take my word.
Yes, of course.
Thank you.
This fine body of a man here.
That's kind of you.
It is important to remember that every gap year is unique, and taking a year out may not be for everyone. But as many people have found, taking a gap year is nothing short of a life-changing experience. Let's see what our experts have to say.
Charlie Brooks, better known as the Scary Pants actress, Janine in EastEnders. Welcome back to Wales.
Thank you.
Now then, we're all wondering, you know, when you started your role in EastEnders, did you think it would become such a significant one?
No, I didn't even know I was going for the part of Mike Reed's daughter, actually.
Between the glitz of the marina and the old town of Penarth lie the Billybank Flats. The estate has been earmarked for demolition for almost 10 years, and the land has been estimated as some of the most valuable real estate in Wales.
And yes, the first category is Grand Slam 2005. So we have 8 categories to go through, and in each category there will be 4 multiple choice answers. Let's kick off with some questions based on this year's triumphant Six Nations Championship. Take a look at this. Stand by for your quick fix of adrenaline. Ben Cohen, how's it going so far? It's a witty tale of mistaken identity and falling in love. Hello and welcome to a brand new series of Hot Houses. Do you think Stephen Sondheim's work will be appreciated now?